Hello. Many of you will recognize this painting. It's by Caspar David Friedrich, and it's called Wanderer Above the Sea of Fog, painted in 1818. But what makes it such an iconic painting? And why has it inspired the marketing of many of today's hottest IPs? Also, how can you, yes you, harness the power of this compositional feature in your own creative endeavors, or pictures you take on your phone? Also, and perhaps most importantly, what does this painting teach us about the human race? We've got a lot to get through. So here we go. This is a video about the power of the Rückenfigur. That's right, Rückenfigur. It's a German word meaning figure shown from the back, same as the word rucksack can mean backpack. The Wanderer, again. The basic geometric shape of the Wanderer is a triangle, which we can see repeated in so many video game and movie posters. But the key to this is the Rückenfigur and what it does for our ideas about heroism. So it's triangular, but it's mostly heroism.
It's mostly heroism!
The fact that we can't see the hero's face is significant. We, as the viewer, stand behind him. He is ahead of us looking out at something beyond. This composition is perfect for the romantic worldview, or Weltanschauung, in which Caspar David Friedrich was painting. Romanticism, according to Wikipedia, was an artistic, literary, musical, and intellectual movement that originated in Europe towards the end of the 18th century in most areas. Oh, hey there! There's Mr. Fog Wanderer. This painting exemplifies many of the romantic ideas about nature being sublime and about life being emotional. And the romantic hero's quest to resist the rise of technology and industry and explore the wild out there in the fog, while also wrestling with the wild nature of man in here. It's very emotional. But this is not limited to men. Here's Caspar David Friedrich's 1820 painting, Woman at a Window, which features, unsurprisingly, a woman at a window. Note too the additional element of the frame within a frame. Countless other Rückenfigur examples exist within painting. We've seen this image many times. Sometimes it's a man looking out of a window. Sometimes a woman not looking at a vase. Sometimes a woman looking at a house. Sometimes Batman looking at Gotham City. So why does it work? What's the appeal? Well, part of the appeal is that the Rückenfigur is a universalizing image, much like the silhouette. In this approach, the figure in the painting or photograph is us, a proxy for the viewer. In Rückenfigur, we live vicariously through the wanderer, or the woman, or Batman. They mediate between us and the world of the painting or scene. They are standing in for us as a federal head of the human race.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
It's a symbolic image. This is not an individual man or woman, but a representative, much like the signs on public toilets or road crossings. The essential element in the symbol is that it is broad and applicable to everyone. But we don't want to be limited to vague conceptual humanity. We need individual human beings too. And this is where the Rückenfigur is more than a symbolic representative. They are not a silhouette or outline, a sign for the toilet, or a figurine on a wedding cake. They are much more a photograph of the happy couple at the end of the aisle. A real man and a real woman, particular people. The only difference is that we can't see their faces. This is actually a picture of me and my wife. I show it because the Rückenfigur wasn't a technique I learned about theoretically, but was something I noticed in practice in my own photographs. I'll just say I'm not a great photographer, but I found that many of my favorite pictures especially many of my children on holiday, were Rückenfigur. I just didn't know the word for it. That last one is Nestor's Cave in the Peloponnese in Greece. Anyway, moving on from the Morgan Locke family album, another question for the Rückenfigur is, what are they looking at? For this, let's turn to 20th century American painter Norman Rockwell. He's known for many things. The Freedom series, that bloke standing up to say something controversial meme, and his cover art from the Saturday Evening Post. Easily sneered at by art snobs who prefer wisps of echoes and abstractions of vibes, Norman Rockwell's work is accused of sentimentality, but he paints a recognizable humanity with humor. His later work also involves social commentary. Rockwell's use of Rückenfigur usually draws attention to what the character or characters can see, and sometimes what can see them. This 1948 painting, Christmas Homecoming, is really more about those welcoming rather than the one returning home for the holidays. This painting of a GI returning has a similar effect. Our attention is drawn first to the joy of the reception committee. Only later do we follow their eyelines and see the soldier boy. Norman Rockwell's Rückenfigurs are inherently relational. Here he shows the shared anxieties of a young woman and a young man in Before the Date. And here again, a teacher touched by her pupil's birthday surprise. As viewers, we join in the scene as participants. Classmates sitting at the back of the room, enjoying her reaction. The relational bonds are especially strong in this famous diner scene, The Runaway from 1958. These three characters are unrelated, but the relational bonds between them are seemingly unbreakable. But Rockwell also uses the Rückenfigur in a more conventional, romantic, heroic sense, as individuals wrestle with the wild world around them, often in the form of a canvas. What should this gentleman make of the splatter painting of Jackson Pollock? Incidentally, you get triple points here. Rückenfigur, frame within a frame, and a checkerboard floor.
Nice.
And if the artist is heroic, which since Romanticism they almost always believe they are, then the artist will live out his adventures with his paintbrush. Here is Rockwell's self-portrait. Still comic, but displaying a man fighting with himself for the duration, while Dürer, Rembrandt, Van Gogh, and Picasso look on. We find in the Rückenfigur then a universal figure, a hero who represents us, but also someone we follow. There are multiple ways in which this works out. Perhaps the Rückenfigur concept is best expressed in open-world video games like Zelda Breath of the Wild. These games place a camera behind the head of the character. The avatar, controlled by the player, is in front of them, seen from behind, heading out into the wild world of Hyrule. This perspectival shift is very different from the left-to-right platform video games of earlier generations, such as Mario, or even the first-person shooters of GoldenEye, or technically not a shooter, but Minecraft. Third-person Rückenfigur composition is the perfect heroic disposition. The Rückenfigur is also the basic perspective of the racing game. Mario Kart also places the camera above and behind the character. It means that the perspective of the player is lined up perfectly with the perspective of the camera. As we turn right, we go right. So the Rückenfigur is a profound compositional tool, easily incorporated into your photographic repertoire if it isn't already. But what does it mean about being human? Well, in the words of Welsh rocker and heart astronomer Bonnie Tyler, and in the words of drummer turned frontman David Grohl, there goes my hero, watch him as he goes. We all want to follow a hero. Psalm 23, is one of the most famous passages in the whole Bible. The image of the Lord as shepherd is identified in the first verse. It's an idea that runs throughout Scripture, and it's why 35% of all Sunday school crafts are about sticking cotton wool balls to pieces of A4 paper. A core picture of the Christian life is the sheep with the shepherd. It's the same reason that one of the first things Jesus says in the Gospels is, "Follow me." Follow me, an inescapable metaphor within our social media vocabulary. And the reason that works is because even though we live in an age of expressive individualism, you and I were made to follow. And that's good news. Many of us feel lost and aimless. The world out there is scary, foggy, and dangerous. The world in here is scary, foggy, and anxious. We're not sure of our purpose or direction in life. The enduring power of the Rückenfigur points us to the fact that we were created to follow after a hero. The Rückenfigur isn't going away anytime soon. I'm Reformed mythologist Nate Morgan Locke. You've been watching Speak Life. I'm glad you were here.